Hello guys and welcome to another tutorial. And in this tutorial we are going to create a mailing system for inside a game, and there will also be an attachment like this. And well, let's put here hello, this is a test. Also here just a g and save it. So there's that. There it is, the G, and now let's send it. And the mail is sent successfully. Fine, and as you can see, when I'm here, an example of mail, you'll get from which the mail is, then a few lines, and then the actual body. And here there will be the file you have chosen to add other attachments. And welcome back guys. I just showed you how it works, or at least I showed you that it works, and now just let me explain everything. This is just an image, and it's just a quad script mail and just a few input fields. These are all those, nothing special. And text that is here, and you'll get there the error, or that it is sent successfully. There's nothing special about those input fields, they're just exactly the same as the normal one, except this one got an email address as content type, and this one got a multi-line new line. The send as will call to the mail tutorial and will start the send mail function. And also, there's one problem with this, or well, it isn't a problem, but I didn't include it. There isn't a file manager, or you just have to type exactly the file name by yourself to include an attachment. So that's a kind of a problem, but it doesn't matter for this tutorial. You can, there are some tutorials on the internet that will show you how to create that. So let me just show you the script. This line is to use the UE system, and those four lines are to send a mail. And this just this for the mail, and this is just for the security. And for most mail hosting sites, you need that also. So there's some input fields, nothing special, and a text, and it will call this, and then it will start a coroutine. Send mail. And you might wonder why did you first didn't put everything on those lines, just directly into this void send mail. So that's because an IEnumerator, you can't see it in the script. If you open this script when you already built the game and someone can access your script, an IEnumerator isn't visible on the script itself, so they won't see that your email, what your email is and what your password. But this line I will explain later on. So first it will return a wait for seconds of 0, and that's just because otherwise the IEnumerator wouldn't work. So after that it will check if there's anything you didn't fill in, and if it didn't, it will set an error text of please fill in all the fields. Nothing special, so but if you did fill in everything, it will create a new mail message, and it will change the from to your email, so that was the input field, your email. It will send it to, well, that's my email address, and the subject will be from the input field subject and from that text, and the body will be first mail from, so we get the real email address of the person who sent this, then a new line with just to make sure you know where to start the message starts, and then we'll get the actual message. Then it will check if it has an attachment. If it has, it will create a new attachment. The attachment will be the path of text, and it will add it to the mail itself. After that, you need to have a client or a server, it's just how you call it, and I use Gmail, so that's why it's standing right here. If you use another service, I think you need to do it different, but I don't know how, and I just always work with Gmail, so that's probably found on internet, but you need to change this part of the script. First, you need to change the port to this. Well, this worked for me, but maybe if it don't work, just change this number. Then it will actually send it, or view who will send it. And that's also here, needs to send your email and here your password. And I have to admit, I don't know exactly how this works, but well, it works. And this, those two lines are for security reasons, but also otherwise, if you don't include this, it won't work for most mailing services, because they will ban you, and it will enable this, and after that we will use the server certificate just to have the security correct, and after that it will send and it will change the error texts to the mail is sent successfully. So after this line, you need to create something like go back to main menu or something like else, but this works. I can't show you again or something like that because I changed this to your email instead of my real email. So I hope you understand this. If you did, please leave, if you have got any questions, please leave it in the comments below. And also, if you like this tutorial, please leave a like or subscribe. And if you've got any request about other tutorials, also put it in the comments. And well, I hope I can see you guys next week.